Hi there. Water. Have you ever wondered where your drinking water comes from? Sure, we can turn the tap and fill our glass, but what's the source of that water? Well, did you know that Canada is surrounded not only by three oceans, but we're also home to the world's largest freshwater lakes? The Great Lakes are the largest system of fresh surface water on Earth. They contain about 18% of the entire world's fresh surface water. The Great Lakes also provide drinking water to 8.5 million Canadians, almost a third of our population. That's a lot of fresh water. However, most of the water that flows on the land within Canada doesn't go into replenishing the Great Lakes or filling up our water glasses. Most of Canada's water flows north, towards the Arctic Ocean. The water that flows from lakes and rivers into the oceans isn't wasted. It's still an essential part of a much larger picture we call the global hydrologic cycle. This water is necessary for navigation, recreation, fish and wildlife support, and waste dilution. It sustains the lifestyles of large and small communities across Canada. And all of these rivers and lakes are part of drainage basins, or watersheds. Did you realize that you're in a watershed right now? What is a watershed? A watershed is defined as an area of land where all the surface water, precipitation included, drains into the same place. We know these as open watersheds. We have a hierarchy of open watersheds ranging from the largest, which drain into oceans, down to the smallest area. Your yard could be a watershed. Even your footprint could be a watershed. The largest open watersheds drain into an ocean. In Canada, water can drain to the Pacific Ocean, the Arctic Ocean, Hudson's Bay, the Atlantic Ocean, and even to the Gulf of Mexico. When you think of water flowing into and out of a watershed, what do you picture? You might think of a watershed as starting high in the mountains and finishing at the ocean, but mountain chains aren't necessarily the border of a watershed. Take our watershed here at Science North. In Greater Sudbury, we're part of the Atlantic watershed. This means the precipitation that falls here will eventually end up in the Atlantic Ocean. However, if we go about 155 kilometers north of Sudbury on Highway 144, we arrive at the Laurentian Divide. Waters north of this area flow towards Hudson's Bay and to the Arctic Ocean. The elevation here is 395 meters. The Laurentian Divide isn't a mountain range like in many other divides in North America. But it's the height of the land that determines whether water flows to the Arctic Ocean or to the Atlantic Ocean. Fun fact, the Laurentian Divide goes all the way south to North Dakota and Minnesota and into a small part of Montana. It often runs through some flat areas, confusing people who visit the watershed markers. So, most of our Canadian waters flow north to the Arctic either directly or via Hudson's Bay because the land is sending the waters in those directions. Because of the slope of the land, and depending on where you're located in your watershed, there could be other local watersheds upstream or downstream of you. This is important because what we put in our water will eventually flow downstream into the nearest large body of water. It could also affect everything along the drainage path. In our neck of the woods, most of our water is flowing into Lake Huron, one of the Great Lakes. Speaking about what we put down our drain, I'd like to make a quick service announcement here. We take for granted that we can rinse a lot of things down the drain, but that's not true. Most stuff, and we'll stick with the kitchen stuff here, should go in the compost or green bin, not down the drain. Specifically, fats, oils, and grease. You might think if you use enough hot water and soap that it won't matter, but most of these fats will solidify. If not in your house plumbing, then further along. Oils will often congeal, and they'll collect any other items that shouldn't have been put down the drain, like floss and wipes. If you're getting grossed out listening to this, think how much the people who work in water treatment enjoy removing enormous fatbergs from the sewage system. Cool the fats and put them in your green bin. Wipe up the oils with a paper towel and put them in your green bin. If you really have too much, collect it and bring it to your city's special waste disposal. They know what to do. We can live weeks without food, but only days without water. We turn a tap and take for granted the water will flow. But not everyone has access to clean, fresh water. It's important that we reflect on how human activities will impact the long-term sustainability of all water systems. We need to make choices that will protect our water heritage for future generations.